Good morning and welcome to the 2016-2017 MIC SAD Prom Disaster Presentation. My name is Ben Cole. I am a member of MIC SAD. Thank you for your time and joining us today.
Hi, my name is Haley Gray and I am also a member of MIC SAD. First off, we'd like to stress the fact that you are not forced to attend this assembly. If you have no desire to be here or choose to be disrespectful and not pay attention, you may sit in the office for the remainder of this assembly.
Hi, I'm Zach Sweeney, another member of MIC SAD. We are missing valuable class time for this presentation, so we ask for your full attention throughout. We don't want to waste your time, and we certainly do not want to waste our own.
Hi, I'm Hannah Stoller, the secretary of MIC SAD. There's been many months and days and time and hours put into this presentation by all of us, and we'd like it if you guys give us your utmost attention and pay attention to the whole thing. Please and thank you.
Hi, I'm Jake Amatangelo, treasurer of MIC SAD. I would like to remind you that any interruptions made during this program will result in immediate removal from the auditorium. So please, give the phones a rest and give your full undivided attention.
Hi, I'm Maggie Schmidt, vice president of MIC SAD. If this presentation can aid in saving just one life and influence students to make the right decisions, then the effort, energy, and time put into making this was well worth it.
Hi, I'm Chase Klingsmith, co-president of MIC SAD. Remember, one bad decision made not only on prom night, but in your everyday life, can affect the lives of your friends, family, and fellow classmates. We cannot emphasize the importance of this assembly enough.
And I'm Megan Christner, co-president of MIC SAD. I'd like to remind you that events like the ones you're about to witness occur in high schools across America every year around this time. The very purpose of this video is to serve as a warning. Please take the message of this video to heart and enjoy the program. Thank you.
Hey Maggie, will you run to prom with me?
Yes! I've been running for so long! When it's cold outside,
I've got the month of May. I guess you say, what can make me feel this way? Maggie,
sorry, Mr. Brown.
You're the only fish in my sea for prom.
Yeah!
Thank you. and ride it. So gone and get to clapping. Go pop it for a plan, pop it for me. Turn around and drop it for a plan, drop it for me. I'll rent some beach house in Miami. Wake up with no jammies. Lobster tail for dinner. Coolio served that scampi. You got it if you want it. Got it if you want it. Said you got it if you want it. Take my wallet if you want it now. Jump in the Cadillac.
Girl, let's put some miles on it.
Anything you want,
just to put a smile on it.
You deserve it, baby. You deserve it all. Jewelry shining so bright. Strawberry champagne.
So where's the after party?
My house?
Yes!
We probably shouldn't have alcohol though. We got a big game in the morning.
Come on, it's senior year.
Oh my gosh. It's senior year. We have
the playoffs. Come on.
Yeah, but it's senior year.
Alright, fine.
Okay, yeah.
You guys can, but I'm not.
Come on.
Buzz You're kill, a party pooper.
Yeah.
Whatever you say.
You're sitting on a table.
Oh, yeah.
Hey guys.
Where did that come from?
What?
Hey guys, when
what?
You spell pepperoni, it has PP in it.
We put the good in the good, in the good life. We put the good in the best.
and it's a moment I could never trade. Yeah, I told my moms not to stress no more. Go hit the beer store and no credit card debts no more. I want the crib and it's an escrow now. And so you don't ever have to worry about how you can pay rent no more. Put my team in a position that we're making a killing. Stacking blue faces right to the ceiling. In Vegas, I'm with a mortar and bottles of the ace in the ceiling. Till there ain't enough space up on the table to fit them. Go ahead and hit it. From here, no more being broke and distressed. I put my heart into this game like I open my chest. We only pray for more M's while you hope for the best. We make these plays, man, I'm finessing these checks. Time's up for everybody, I'm collecting old debts. And I swear this champagne just tastes better on jets. I'm just out here being dreaming, this is real as it gets.
Okay, there's
the list.
Yeah.
What?
What?
You should go to the school.
Okay.
That's an idea. We're gonna get in trouble.
It's no, such a no,
guys.
No,
my so dad's fun. A cop.
No one cares. We're going.
Well, if you put it that way.
Yeah.
Ready? Yeah! Yeah!
Really be doing this?
Yeah!
Yeah! Yeah! Come on, we're gonna get in trouble.
We're seniors. Who cares?
Please, this could mess us up for the rest of our lives. Really, guys?
Dr. Moon, you've reached Hal Vernon.
I can't remember a time I was wrong. Man, thanks, little boat. Hey, man. That's what I'm
here for. Get your BTS out of here!
You think you're bad, so maybe a little baby. No. I don't want to lie.
Oh, my God. This is what I want to hear in your head. This is for educational purposes only.
I can't use the VPN?
No! I'm at it! Wait. With you and your VPN, you say so
fun!
Hey, Dr. Boone! Hey, Dr. Boone! Hey, Dr. Boone!
Hey, get your VPNs out of my office!
Okay, yeah. Dr. Boone. You missed.
Guys, you're wrong. It's Mr. Boone. Thank you very much. He got his mystery at the University of Pittsburgh.
Clearly. Oh, okay. Yeah.
What do you even mean?
Yeah. Ah, you're wasting our balloon.
Yeah, where
are
we going?
What's the whip?
answers.
Done. We haven't eaten anymore. This is the playoffs.
Bro,
you're working fine. You're
pitching and playing first base. What are you gonna do? You're a first relief pitcher. Dude, you aren't gonna be sober by then.
I'm sleeping off.
Coffee doesn't do anything. You're still gonna be drunk, dude. It's the most important game of your life. It's the playoffs. Not if we all win. Not if we all show up drunk.
Yeah.
No, I don't want that. Pretty easy, dude. I'm going home. Amy, let's go. I gotta sleep.
Okay.
No! Don't leave the party!
I'm sorry.
Everyone said see you later.
I'll be back to get you in a second, sir. Let me get your seatbelt off. I'll be back. Thank you. Still found him out of the car. We're going to go into our cells for right this second, sir. We're going to get you processed, and I'm going to start typing some charges.
Charges?
Yes, charges.
Can I call my parents?
I will try and see if I can get you a phone call, but for right now, you need to go into the cells with me.
I have to go into a cell?
Yes, you have to go into a cell.
Can I call my parents?
We'll get you a phone call, but you need to step in the cell for right now. Step up against this wall. Step up against the wall. Do not turn back towards me. Step against the wall.
I'm not a bad person.
Nobody's saying you're a bad person, but you made an awful mistake tonight.
Is everyone okay?
No, and everybody's not okay. You killed one person, and one person seriously injured and go into a Pittsburgh trauma center. When I take this cuff off, you're going to place your hand on top of your head. Do you understand me? Do you understand me? When I take this cuff off, you're going to place your hand on top of your head.
Yes, yes.
Hand on top of your head. Other hand is going to go on top of your head. Do you understand?
Yes.
I'm going to pat you down one last time. I'm going to ask you again. There's nothing on you that's going to poke me, stick me, anything like that.
No. What's going to happen to me?
Right now, you're going to be processed, and I'm going to type up charges, and then we're going to see if we can't get you in front of a judge.
What kind of charges?
Charges? Yeah. Homicide by vehicle? Friggin' aggravated assault by vehicle while DUI? There's a whole list of charges. Turn around.
Am I going to jail?
We're going to see whether our judge sets bail or bond for you, but you need to have a seat on the seat right now. You need to go ahead and let your hands down. You need to take your shoes or your laces out of your shoes off. Okay.
We're going to take my shoes.
I'm just going to put them right out here so you have nothing you can harm yourself with. All right. Next process is going to be we're going to get you fingerprinted and photographed and ready to be arraigned by the judge. Do you have any questions at this point?
No.
All right, stay here, stay calm, and I'll be back with you as soon as I can.
What did I do? Oh, what did I do?
Step through here.
What are we doing in here?
We're going to have you processing you. We're going to get your fingerprints taken. We're going to get a photograph. Go ahead and sit on this chair right here. Hang on there for a second. I'm going to ask you a series of questions.
How long am I going to be here?
Hopefully, we're going to get you out of here as soon as we can, but I need to get all this stuff completed before I can let you go, okay? Before I can even take you in front of the judge.
Who's the judge?
The judge is Magistrate Christner.
Is he nice?
He's a very fair individual and a very fair judge. What's your first name, sir?
Jake.
Jake or Jacob?
Jake.
J-A-K-E.
Yes.
Last name, sir?
Amatangelo.
Spell that for me.
A-M-A-T-A-N-G-E-L-O.
A-M-A-T-A-N-G-E-L-O, correct?
Yes.
What's your date of birth, sir?
March 20th, 1998. Can I call my mom? Is she coming?
Our officers are trying to get in touch with your parents right now.
Can I call her?
No, I can't let you have a phone call right now until I'm done processing you. Have you ever been fingerprinted before, sir?
Yes.
Have you ever been fingerprinted on a live scan machine before?
Yes.
Okay. Anything I wipe on your fingers is going to be water or water-based. Go ahead, stand up. Come on over here to my right side. I'm going to give you a couple of these. These are simply sand wipes. They're to keep your fingertips moist. The computer's going to show us which fingers we're going to do. You're going to start with your right four fingers. Please wipe those, get those clean. Relax your wrist and let me do it from here. Step back. Thank you.
What do you need these for?
Everybody who's facing criminal charges in the state of Pennsylvania gets fingerprinted and submitted to the state police database. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to roll each print individually, so relax your wrist and let me do it. Next thing we're going to do is your palm. Wet your palm down for me.
I'm not a bad person.
But you made some very bad mistakes tonight. Wet the top of your palm. Top. All right, we're gonna switch to your left hand, left four fingers. Left thumb. Okay, put your fingers down again. We're gonna roll each one individually, sir. Palm.
Okay.
Left middle finger.
My parents are going to kill me. I've never done anything wrong before. I got pulled over for speeding once, that's all.
Well, you made some bad decisions tonight that's led to some very serious consequences, not only for you and your family, but for a young lady's family and another young lady who's injured's family.
Is she gonna be okay?
I don't know. I had to deal with you. I didn't have time to do ambulance. Upper palm, sir. I know that she's in very serious condition and they were life-flighting her to a Pittsburgh trauma center.
I've been her friend for so long. I took her to prom this year.
You took her to prom?
Yes.
Well, I think a better friend would have not have been drinking and driving. Next thing we're gonna do is your photographs. Okay, I need you to step over here, step up against that gray border right there, look straight at the camera. I'll take the...
Why do I have to take my picture?
Because it's part of the processing that everybody gets photographed and fingerprinted.
Is my family gonna see this?
These are private photos that only stay with this department as part of your criminal history. Look straight at the camera, sir.
What else do I have to do?
We're going to get you processed completely, and then I'm going to put you back in the cell while I prepare the charges that are going to be filed against you. Go ahead and have a seat in the green chair, sir.
I don't feel good.
You don't feel good. Imagine how that family's going to find out when they find out their daughter's dead.
I've never done anything wrong before.
Alright, so we're gonna place you back in the cell while we wait for the judge. Let's stand back up. What?
I don't have to put the handcuffs back on, do I?
No, I'm not gonna re-handcuff you, but I am gonna secure you back in the cell.
Yeah, I know, like seriously. Like this is literally serious. Oh my gosh. I don't know how you guys sit down because this is ridiculous. Why did this have to happen? Like, why did he even have to do any of this? No, I know. This is just stupid. I hope they're okay.
They will have to be here.
What about the third?
Yeah, we'll talk about
it. So, I understand Maggie was in the scene. Unfortunately, she died the same.
Oh my god.
You're kidding, right? I am not joking. This is really serious, guys. We're calling their families and getting them here, but this is a big problem. And I understand that there was drinking going on. Part of this is because there was drinking and driving.
Why? Why would this have to happen?
Part of this is, again, because there was drinking and then driving. And anytime alcohol is involved, bad things can happen. Unfortunately, in this case, two of your friends are being flown to a trauma center and one didn't make it. Due to alcohol.
It wasn't worth it. None of this was worth it.
No. This was so stupid. Why did anyone have to do that? This isn't even worth the heartache. Just think, she's not even able to graduate anymore. Or go to college.
She was supposed to go to Mercyhurst.
Play softball.
Chase, you were supposed to go to college in D.C.
All that gone to the idea.
Can't believe this happened to us.
Make sure that you understand what you're charged with. Answer any questions that you may have. And I'll ask you a series of questions, all of which dealing with vulnerable issues. At no time will we discuss anything about guilt or innocence. And I'll make sure that you understand your rights. Are you charged with homicide by vehicle while driving under the influence of alcohol? Now you need to recognize if you're found guilty of that charge, it carries a mandatory minimum of 3 years in jail. You're charged with aggravated assault by vehicle while DUI. Now recognize that charge in itself, you could be facing a maximum of 10 years in jail. You're charged with DUI, meaning that you were over the legal limit. The legal limit in the state of Pennsylvania is 0.08. You're charged with DUI by a minor. I recognize that a minor cannot have any alcohol in his bloodstream. His or hers. And you're also charged with underage drinking, purchase, possession, consumption, and or transportation of alcohol. Now, we're going to ask some questions. We're going to get to know you a little bit. All right, first of all, I must make a comment. You look a lot better in your baseball uniform. And that's what I'm used to seeing. Unusual that I have to see people from the community charged with crimes such serious as where somebody gets actually hurt. But that's what we ask them. And I know a little bit about you, but I'm going to ask you more. How old are you?
I'm 18.
What about
you? I'm 18.
And where do you live?
Ross River Township.
And you lived in Ross River your entire life?
Yes.
And you lived with your parents?
I do.
And how's your grades?
They're good. I'm a 4.0 student.
And your plans for after high school?
I'm going to St. Vincent College for physical therapy.
All right, have you ever been arrested before?
I have not.
Ever been charged with any type of crime?
I have not.
Ever been any warrants for your arrest?
No.
You have the right to secure counsel of your choice. That means an attorney of your choice. If you can't afford to hire an attorney, one will be appointed to represent you in charge. Any thoughts on an attorney?
No.
Have you talked to your parents yet?
I have not.
Do you want to apply for a public defender, or do you think you're going to hire private counsel?
Hire private.
You do? Any idea who that may be?
No.
Okay. You recognize that if you're unable to afford an attorney, you can get a public defender?
Yes.
Okay. All right, you have a right to a preliminary hearing within 3 to 10 days. Your hearing is scheduled for the 22nd, it would be 10 days from today, 22nd day of May. Unless it's continued for a good cause or waived to the court of common pleas. All right, I'm at that juncture in the arraignment process where you have an opportunity to address the court. Recognize that this one stroke of the pen by this by myself, and your freedom is taken away. Yeah. Would you like to address the court?
Yes.
You may.
This is the first mistake I've made. I'm a 4.0 student. I've never been in trouble with the law before. It was just a group of friends trying to have fun, and I understand that I made a mistake.
And?
I am very sorry for it.
Yeah, I understand that, but how does that play into my thought process?
Doesn't.
Both do. Are you indicating to the court that you think you're worthy of consideration?
No.
Oh, you're not? Oh, that's resounding. All right, Cobalt, have anything to offer before I sit down?
Your Honor, we've just asked that the court take into consideration the severity of the incident here. We have one fatality, we have one very serious injury that we're aware of now, and at least one other minor, possibly serious injury. We're asking that some type of significant monetary loan be placed on him to ensure something like this doesn't happen again.
All right, Mr. Amatangelo, the Commonwealth points out some very important facts, one of which is serious is now recognize that bond is always to secure your appearance in trial. It's not supposed to be used as a punishment. But the severity of the charges changes the complexion. Changes the complexion of the entire thought process of the court. So therefore, I'm going to set your bond at $250,000, 10% accepted. Now, that means that your premiums can post a percentage to take the $25,000, or you can use property that is valued at the equivalent of $250,000. If bond is not posted, you're going to be placed in a Westmoreland County Detention Center, and you'll be held there until bond is posted. Or lower.
Imagine there's imagine no possessions.